internet. It goes without saying that without it, you wouldn't be watching this video. But beyond that, I can almost guarantee you that your life would change. And honestly, I don't think it would be for the better. So what would we do and how would we survive in an offline world? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer a whole breadth of questions on a number of different topics. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if the internet was shut off for a year? I don't know about you, but even saying those words makes me feel a little bit panicked. Before we get into talking about this assured dystopia, why don't you let me know what you would do should we ever lose our mate the net? Also, while you're down there and the internet still works, why don't you give this video a thumbs up and share it with a friend? Okay, the internet. We wake up one day and honey has gone fishing. Then we find out it's for a whole year. Blimey, what the actual frog would we do? Maybe the answer lies 23 years ago, back in good old humble 1995. Back then, fewer than 1% of people were online. Now, in the United States of America, 73% of people use it daily, and 90% of adults use it at least once every 3 months. As older generations die out, the amount of people who cannot remember a life without the internet increases. Would we be equipped to deal with a year-long outage? Firstly, how on earth could the internet be shut off for a year? And would we know that it was just a year? What if we thought it was forever? Would it be as a result of a cyber attack, a natural disaster, a nuclear disaster, a solar storm, a government kill switch, the apocalypse? The factors causing the outage would wildly affect the answer to this question. For now, let's assume that it just sort of magically disappears for a bit. Well, firstly, speaking of the apocalypse, if the internet stopped working worldwide for more than about 6 minutes, there would be mass panic in all first and second world nations, as well as huge pockets of panic in third world nations. Over 50% of the world's population uses the internet. Assuming we didn't know it was just for a year, the end could seemingly be nigh. People would run to stores and stockpile food. Hundreds of millions, if not billions of people would immediately be out of work. People's houses would be at risk. People's lives would be in jeopardy. Panic may lead to riots and likely an increase in suicides. This chaos wouldn't be great for many reasons, one being that it could encourage world leaders to enact martial law. Although it would be an end to his tweeting days, Trump would probably love to rule the states with emergency powers and without the internet to encourage public outcry at some of his actions. Let's say the panic settled down after a few weeks. This is the kind of world people would need to adjust to. There would be no social media, no YouTube, no Twitch, no Instagram, no online news ready to read at the touch of a button. People would be less informed. Entertainment would be harder to consume. On the flip side, though, there would be a resurgence in TV, radio, and print journalism. The dinosaurs of the entertainment and communication world would rejoice at their main competitors being wiped out. To be honest, I wouldn't be surprised if one of the dwindling networks or print publications were behind the sabotage. The United States economy would be in jeopardy, and it would probably take the biggest worldwide hit, especially in states like California, which rely heavily on tech. Apple sales would drop. There'd be no Google, no Uber, no Amazon. It would go bust. Goodbye, Silicon Valley. Goodbye, cryptocurrencies. Of course, beyond the United States, almost all worldwide economies would be in jeopardy, and the inevitable rush on the banks would lead to a worldwide banking crisis. Think about it. Without the internet, there'd be no internet banking, which would mean a horrifying return to cash and checks. People would rush to banks to try and draw out their money. The banks wouldn't be able to deal with the demand, and they would likely close or operate under restricted hours and special measures. This would put many people without an abundance of cash at risk of being penniless while the banking crisis was resolved. Look at Greece from 2009. Businesses in general would suffer, even if they aren't internet-based. Most businesses use the internet in some form, and undoing all the progress we've made since 1995 would be a pure and utter headache. No internet? Wave a happy return to travel agents and taxi cabs. Ugh. Some may see this as a good thing, others not so much, but let's welcome back libraries. While this may be great for local communities, we would be kidding ourselves if we thought that without the internet, education wouldn't suffer. Because it would. Books are great for literature and sparking imaginations, but they're terrible for delivering pinpointed information. We could no longer find answers at the touch of a button, which would undoubtedly make people less curious. If information was an effort, who would seek it? Public travel would be mainly unaffected initially. Planes can still fly without the internet, trains and buses can continue to run to schedule. However, long-term internet outages would start to have an effect on logistics and communications. How would a company communicate a cancellation? location. Personally, I don't know what I would do in Canada without my transport app. It tells me when the buses or trams are coming so I can leave my house at the right time. In the winter, I might freeze in minus 20 degrees Celsius weather waiting for a delayed bus. Speaking of freezing, we would all need to stay tuned to the weather reports on the TV and radio, as there would be no app to help a honey out with her outfit choice for the day. Speaking of apps, we would be lost without Google Maps. How would we get sushi delivered to our door at 1 a.m. without Just Eat? We couldn't. Without the internet, our options would be limited, and we'd be slowed down. Dare I even say the words postal service at this point? Bye emails, hello clogged postal system, and goodbye rainforest. Paperless is out for a year. Final thing, even after the initial panic, psychologically, we would be stressed out. Sure, we might talk to the people immediately surrounding us, but we may lose the contact we have learned to rely on with our more distant friends. I live overseas and phone calls are infrequent and less practical than WhatsApp. Not only that, our telecommunication systems would be overloaded without the internet. If we were all trying to make calls instead of sending texts, phone lines wouldn't be able to handle the demand. When the internet came back on, I'd like to say we would have a finite appreciation for life, but we wouldn't. There'd probably be a mass celebration across the world. The internet, after all, is key to human progression. It's connected us, it's made us faster and more efficient, and like, let's be honest, who can live without memes? So that is one question answered for you there. Why don't you let me know what you would do without the internet? Also, while you're down there, why don't you leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend? For now, I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.